Today we're going to play around with some compositing. Hey guys, welcome to Phlearn. My name's Aaron Nace. You can find me on Twitter at AKNacer. Today we are doing some really cool stuff with compositing. We're using two of the family's images and I can't wait to get into it. It's going to be a lot of fun. You guys are going to learn quite a bit. We just launched a new print store here on Phlearn.com and you can get to it. There's a link right up at the top. And right now, this week only, we are actually giving away a free print. So there's a giant banner up at the top of this page and you can see, you can enter it in. All you have to do is enter our newsletter for a chance to win. If you guys already are a part of our newsletter, you're already entered to win. So look at that. You didn't even have to do anything. You just had to be a loyal, awesome Phlearn subscriber. So let's get into our tutorial. This is a really cool image. We have our image. This is by Claude, Lisa Dick, and this is by, I think it's called Baarnijs. If I didn't pronounce that correctly, I apologize. Basically, what we want to do here is Claude sent, you know, along with this image, he was like, man, if there was a good way to select out, you know, just these blinds here to kind of clean this up. And there is a good way to do it, but there's not really a quick way to do it. I mean, basically, if you wanted to go through, you know, something like this and use like the polygonal lasso tool and you wanted to clean this area up and you could click there and then click there and then click there and there we go, make a selection out of that, grab like your brush tool and paint with white. You could do that and it definitely would work. You would just have to do it over and over and over again. So there really is no, not much of a quicker way to do that because of, you know, the blinds are inconsistently space between each one of them, like this, you know, this space is a little bit less than that space, and there's quite a bit going on. So what I figured I would do, instead of instead of trying to fix this up, which sometimes it's just easier to replace it with something else. So we're gonna just take one of these windows from this image and replace it, so why not? It'll be fun. So basically what we're gonna do is I'm gonna grab my marquee tool, and we're just going to select out this window with a little bit of a border around it. I'm going to use my move tool, so just hit V for that, and then hold down the shift key and click and drag from one image to another one. There we go. And here we go. Now we have a new window in this image. So the only thing we're going to run into here is the fact that this window is way smaller than the rest of the image. Like the, you know, this image is quite large, so we're going to need to upscale the image. Now, we can upscale the window by quite a bit, or I can just downscale the background a little bit. Normally, you would just want to find a window. Now, why is this actually helpful? That's a good question. Well, oftentimes there are things in your images that you just don't like, and trying to like clone stamp them out and things like that can be difficult. But let's say you could go out and photograph another window, something like that, and then replace it in this image. So this has just happened to be some images that we had from the contest, but if you went out and photographed like another window or a version with it closed, or went in a different day and photographed that, you could pretty easily replace that window with a different window. So I'm going to show you guys how to do it from a window that looks, well, absolutely nothing like the window in the actual image, but I'm going to show you guys, you can still make it look pretty good. And if it did look anything like the window, you could make it look very good using the same techniques. Okay. So what I'm going to do is, let's just scale my background down a little bit. I'm going to hold down the Alt or Option key, double click on it, because it's a background and it's locked. So if I hold Alt or Option and double click, it will take off the lock. And then I'm just going to scale that down just a bit there, and that's using my transform tools. Now I'm going to Command click on that, which turns it to selection, go to Image, and down here to Crop. All right, and we'll deselect. So now we did scale the image down, but we don't have to scale this window up quite as far, which means you're going to get a little bit less distortion and things like that. It's not going to look as pixelated. Okay, so how do we get this window to look like it's this window? Well, it's really not that hard. There's a couple of things that we want to follow, and those are basically like, you know, basic perspective rules. So on a new layer, you don't have to do this. I'm just kind of like drawing these out. These are our basic perspective guides. I'm going to just kind of follow some of these lines that are in the image and fill them with, you know, bright color so I can see what I'm doing. So I'm following these perspective lines. You know, the blinds start here and they go kind of down at an angle like that. And let's just fill that in with the area like that. So you can see this is like basically, if you guys have ever studied, you know, perspective and things like that, that's going to create a vanishing line. And eventually those will go to the horizon. They're going to connect to the horizon. Think of like train tracks. They go off in the distance and they meet in the horizon. So similar thing. All we have to do is get this window here to basically line up. So they're horizontal right now, these lines, because we're looking straight at them. We just need to make them look like they're converging. So let's bring the opacity down just a bit on that. And I'm going to hit Command T, which is going to bring up our transform dialog. Now, we're just going to hold down the Shift key, making sure we're maintaining our proportions. And I'm going to line up our edges right about there. All right. And that looks pretty good. Now I'm going to hit Enter by accident, but you don't have to. Now what we're going to do is change our perspective. And to do that, hit Command T again. Hold down the Control or the Command key and click on one of these corners. And then hold down the Shift key and hold down the Option key. So right now I'm holding down Shift, Option, Command. If you guys are on a PC, it's going to be Shift, Alt, or Control. And now we can actually just adjust our perspective, which is really, really cool. And you can see I'm scrolled up a little too far there. But I am changing the perspective of my window. Now, also keep in mind, I can get it like pretty close. But if this isn't lining up here, I can just hold down the Control key and just pull out, you know, one of these corners at a time. So really easily, I'm able to just kind of warp this window into a place that actually like fits into the overall, the overall perspective of this image. There we go. So holding down, again, the Control or the Command key, we're able to just warp this around. And then instead of looking straight at it, it's, you know, the window's actually following the perspective of the room, which is perfect. There we go. Let's hit Enter, and that's our window. So the before was just straight on, and now the after is in the same perspective. So that's taken care of. Now let's go ahead and put a layer mask on there. And I'm just going to put a layer mask on there and paint with black right here on my layer mask. And we're just going to paint directly over some of these areas that are not necessarily as needed. And then we're going to try to do some blending and things like that. There we go. Let's bring that down just a little bit. All right. I feel a sneeze coming on. That was fun. Glad you got to watch someone sneeze on video today. All right. I can't stop it. Once it starts, you can't stop a sneeze. All right. So there we go. That's our new window. And you can see it's relatively, you know, it's in the same perspective as the rest of the window, which is great. Now, it doesn't look like it should belong where the rest of the window is. And that's because the colors are totally messed up. It doesn't, you know, it's the wrong color. So what we're going to use is we're going to use a curves adjustment layer to get our colors where we want them. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use a clipping mask to make sure that curves adjustment layer only affects this current layer. So here's how we do that. We grab our curves adjustment layer. And you can see, I'll just play around here. You can make it lighter or darker. Let's just go ahead and make it quite a bit lighter so you can see all the detail here. Now, if I want this layer to only affect this layer, which this is the layer where our window is, then all I have to do is right click, and I'm going to go up here to create clipping mask. And now all of a sudden, this layer, the curves adjustment layer 1, is only affecting the window, which is perfect. So let's just click back in here. I'm going to make this a little bit darker. There we go. And I'm just going to look at my colors. Between our three color channels, red, green, and blue. Let's start with our blue channel. Do we need more blue or less blue? If we need more, just click and drag it up. If you need less, click and drag it down a little bit. All right, so less seems to be working pretty well. Now let's try just our red channel. Do we want more red or less red? Well, this has a lot of red, this not much red. So we'll just click and drag this up just a bit. And there we go. Now our reds look a little bit better. Our green channel, that can be a little bit harder, but usually you want to add a little bit more green because magentas, you usually don't get a lot of magentas in photos. So when you're kind of adjusting these, you want a little bit more green usually. All right, and then RGB is just light and dark. So let's kind of like bring that down. There we go. And we can see just with this curves adjustment layer, we've taken a window that, you know, is from a completely different image, completely different perspective, all that, and it's already blending in quite well. So that's good news. And already it looks, you know, it really doesn't look that bad. I mean, it doesn't look like the original window, obviously, but it doesn't look that bad. So the next thing I want to do here, we're just going to put a little bit of trim work on here. I'm going to grab my lasso tool again. We're going to grab one of these boards here. There we go. Just kind of selecting right around one of our boards. All right. And if you click a space and you don't like it, by the way, I just did that, hit the delete key or the backspace key. And it's just going to backspace the last one you did. There we go. Now, on this layer, which is our background layer, I'm going to hit Command-J. And what that does is just duplicates that onto a new layer. So on a new layer, we have just a board. Okay. And now what am I going to do with this board? Well, I can do whatever I want with it, really. But I'm going to kind of make it fit over top of all of our other windows, over top of our new window. There we go. So I'm just kind of placing it in there. And all right. Now, this is something that will work on just about any photo that you decide to do. Let's go ahead and flip that horizontally. I think it's going to look better that way. This will work on any photo you do. Obviously, I'm spending a little bit less time than you probably would on your final photo. There we go. That looks pretty good too. And so you would want to spend a bit more time and use just like a higher resolution image that you would take specifically for this purpose. But this is just a good demonstration on, you know, what you can do with replacing one element from another, even if they're in the wrong perspective, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Obviously, we've taken something that was not at all designed to go together here, and we're still putting them together. So I think it's a pretty cool example of just something you guys can do. And this is not something I would put in my portfolio by any means, but if you were in a pinch and like a client was like, oh, we really need that window to be replaced, instead of, you know, trying to clone it out or something like that, you could just use a different window. There we go. And that looks decent. Now let's just shift click all those layers. These are each individual layers that I've just transformed into place. I'm going to hit Command E, which is going to merge them all together. There we go. And now we just need to make this look a little bit more like, hey, it should actually be there. So it's too red. Can you guys see it's like, it's kind of stands out. So I'm going to hit Command U, which is our hue saturation. And I'm going to bring our saturation down just a bit. There we go. And that's going to make it kind of blend in quite a bit better. So it was red because this wall over here is quite red. And then we'll just bring our lightness down. There we go. All right, pretty cool. And then we'll put a layer mask here and I'll kind of just fade this away. Make it look like it's, you know, actually, there we go. Actually kind of like blending in to everything rather than having sharp borders. So just a couple quick tips that you guys, you know, if your border wasn't looking right, then you can just go add that. And you could add that to those things as well. So just a really cool, quick way to completely replace a window from an image that obviously is just completely, totally different. But when just a couple steps, you can see, bring that window in, warp it into place, use a curves adjustment layer to kind of get your colors right. That can take a little bit of work. So if you don't get it immediately, don't worry about it. You can always open up your curves adjustment layer and play around with this after the fact. Like, oh, I want this darker, I want it lighter. Whatever you want to do, you can always change this after the fact. Just double click right over here on your little symbol. And then we just put a fascia on there, and those were a couple lines to help us out with our perspective. So yeah, you guys can see, really didn't take too long, and just a good way to kind of do a bit of compositing. Now, I chose a window, very clumsy over here apparently. I chose a window because obviously there's a window there. There needed to be a light source kind of coming in because that's what's gonna actually color our, or light our subject and color our subject as well. So we chose the window, we colored it correctly and put it in place, guys. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, just kind of like a cool, quick, fun thing. If you guys have any uses for this, let me know. If you have anything that you're like, well, actually that could be really cool in this certain situation. Maybe you took a picture and there was like an ugly like brown door in a room and you wanted it to be like a nice door. Well, you could go take a picture of a cool, nice door that you like and just kind of replace it. Just match the color and you'll be good. So. Awesome, guys. Thanks so much for watching Phlearn. I hope you learned a lot, and make sure to check out our print store available right now. Phlearn, you guys later. Bye, everyone. Want to see something really impressive? See?